20 teaching and non-teaching staff of Rosary College Navalim held a dharna after one of the administrative staff, Vinicia Pimenta, was orally terminated from her service by the principal. They said that Vinicia had helped one student to get a subject of his choice. They alleged that the principal, Father Simeon Dinis, accused Vinicia of bypassing him and told her not to report from next day. Staff said that the principal had retired on 31st July and was continuing in office without government order. When contacted by our reporter, Principal Father Simeon Dinis refused to speak on camera.
Teaching and non-teaching staff of Rosary College Navalim struck work on Friday. They said they have complained to the Internal Complaints Committee and will approach the Directorate of Higher Education with a complaint about the termination of a non-teaching staff.
The all standing over here is because of me. This incident started on the 11th of August when I didn't even knew the full matter. On 11th August around 4 o'clock, at 2 o'clock, father was just passing by my cabin, but he did not even say anything to me. But at 4 o'clock, he asked the staff on top, what is my sign out time? Then they said it's a 4:15. So directly at 4 o'clock, he comes down and he calls me, just stop your work and just lock everything and come on top. So I didn't know what was the matter, so I directly went with him on top. He took me to his cabin. He made me sit down over there. He told me, see, just tell me the truth. I said, okay, fine, I'll tell you, father. Then he started. Did you call up Shailendra? Then I guessed that this matter would be of admission. I said, father, yes. I messaged him. He's like, who are you to do this? I said, father, I just went in to do all because of a student, to help a student. It was nothing. Personal thing. But then he started saying, personal, who are you? We have the authority. You are who to take all this decision. I said, father, I never said anything that I'm going to give the admission or whatever. I just took the names, I gave it to the vice principal, and then because it was a system problem, there was some system problem, that's why the students were approaching. He's like, whatever it is, you have to approach me, that is principal and the vice principal or the admission committee. Then I said, father, I don't have, as the students are coming to me, I just help them. Then I told him, father, I just gave the names to the vice principal and the system administrator. But then the system administrator told me that one person, outside person, that is named Shailendra, he's doing it. So I just sent the names to Shailendra also saying, Shailendra, I've already, just see. But then the messages, whatever for communication between me and Shailendra is nothing so bad that I have forced that person to do that subject change or whatever. But father is making such a thing that I have really changed the subject. And then it happened, now this thing was happening from 4 o'clock till 4:30, 4:40 it was there. Then after that he told me from tomorrow you don't join. So I said, I begged for him, I cried, I said, father, please, this is a scenario that even if I lose a job, it's very difficult for me to go for another job. He said, I don't know. Then I said, father, what I should tell at my parents at home? He's like, that why should I bother? You have done a mistake. I said, father, it was not a mistake, I told him, I begged. It happened. I waited for him till 6:45 over here. But then he ignored me. Then the next day I came. Next day again I started. I went to him. I started begging. He's like, I cannot give you. I cannot change my mind. I cannot do anything. I said, father, please give me a last chance. I begged. I said, father, please. I went to him at least more than 5 times. It happened on 11th, then 12th I went. Again yesterday I went. But yesterday after that, he told me, you please don't stay in the campus, you go. This is an education institution, don't stay in the campus. Then I was standing on the, I was sitting on the sofa over there. After that, he said, you please don't stand here. It is embarrassing for me. I said, father, for me, it's not embarrassing because it's a job for me. He's like, you are telling the principal, this is principal order, you move from here. Then after that, the teachers just approached him. That's it.
A complaint to the Internal Complaints Committee. Okay. And as Ms. Audrey has just said, we are planning to go to the DHE right now and give the complaint to the DHE director, because we feel this is unfair, unjust, just verbally telling a staff member to not come to the college, not to report to college, and not allowing her to sign the master for two consecutive days. Okay, and she was just standing there at the entrance. it was taken, the master was taken away, okay? And she was standing at the entrance, very miserable, and seeing her, we even felt like, you know, she might harm herself. And we even spoke this to the principal and said, like, you know, well, she may commit suicide or something. He said, it's my responsibility. I will take responsibility for that.
We are here fighting for justice for one of our staff members. She's part of the non-teaching staff who has been asked by the principal, Reverend Dr. Simone Denise, not to report to work anymore. Her only error was she had tried to help some student in online admissions to get the subjects that they wanted. He felt that she had surpassed his authority. Now, for the past 2 days, she has been begging of him to report back to work, and he has shown no compassion to her. She has been working hard for the past 8 years for our institution, and we feel that it is very unjust on his part to be doing the same. Secondly, this is the time of the pandemic. I think we should be showing concern and compassion for the working staff. We are also unclear whether he can continue as principal in the institution as his tenure is already over.
For Prime, video journalist Gaurang Malkarnikar, Madgaon.